Good evening and welcome to Village Romeoville's workshop meeting this Wednesday, February 7th, 2024, at 6 p.m. Can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Palmer. Trustee Chavez.
Here.
Trustee Clancy.
Here.
Trustee Richards.
Here.
Trustee Griffin.
Here.
Trustee Gary.
Here.
Mayor Anouk.
Here.
We have a quorum.
Trustee Griffin, will you lead us in the pledge?
Yes.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Very good. It's the Mr. Potter Show tonight. First item up is Ordinance 24-1898, an ordinance approving a rezoning of territory for 201 East Romeo Road.
Thank you, Mayor and Board. If it pleases the Board, we could take both ordinances at the same time.
Sure. Ordinance 24-1899, ordinance approving special use permit plan unit development, final development plan for Properties LLC 201 East Romeo Road. Yeah, you say it right, not me.
All right.
I get tongue-tied on that one.
Thank you, Mayor. We have final development plans before you tonight for the redevelopment of 201 East Romeo Road, which is located on the south side of Romeo Road, east of Route 53, and is currently occupied with a vacant building that was operated as several former restaurants. The plan is to convert the building into a multi-tenant light industrial building. So the first part of the request is to rezone the property from B2 community business to PB plan business, which would allow light industrial use but not allow heavier industrial uses and outside storage. The zoning of this property would be the same as our modern business parks, and the users would be comparable to the users found in the smaller Paragon multi-tenant light industrial building along Taylor Road. The redevelopment will include several improvements to the building and to the site. The building would be split into four units. Each unit would be about 1,900 square feet. Each unit will include updated restroom units, a new fire sprinkler system will be installed for the building, and overhead doors will be provided for each unit. Parking lot will be repaved to include new landscape islands, ADA parking stalls, and parking lot lighting. The site will have a total of 34 parking spaces, and none will be permitted for any truck parking. A new 50-foot landscape yard is provided for the front. New landscaping is also provided around the building, along the detention area, the new detention area, and in the parking lot as well. The building will include an upgraded facade, which will include new decorative siding and gable roof accents on the building, among other features. Due to the reuse of the existing building, there are a few minor code exceptions that are included in the packet. Development Review Committee has reviewed the project, and the Planning and Zoning Commission held a public hearing on January 23rd and recommended approval. This concept was before you a year ago, actually, and we've been working with the project team for several months at this point. We do have the project manager here in attendance, available to answer any questions, and I would be happy to answer any questions.
Very good. As you said, this is something we've already seen for a year already, gone through planning and zoning. Any questions or comments? Anything else you want to add, Trustee Richards?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. First off, I think this is a great use for this property and one that should succeed and do very well there. Planning and zoning had a few minor issues that were all addressed. The old drive around the back that was used by some of the restaurant facilities will be removed. The property is going to be basically look like new. It's going to be all cleaned up. And those are the kind of things that they were concerned with. Some of the parking lot questions, we know the parking lot there has been an issue over years, and it looks like that's all being addressed as well as far as water flow, and there should be no issues there. So ultimately, they were fine with it and voted to approve.
Great. Any other questions or comments?
Mayor?
Mr. Schultz, please.
Yes, thank you, Mayor Young. I reviewed all the exhibits and read the PZZ's report. One of the good things about this, from the way I see it, is we're going to gut that building finally.
and turn it into something I think is going to be more useful for the municipality. And I think this is a good move. It's a great, I want to say thanks to the people that are doing it. I think this is going to work out really well. That's all I had to say, Mayor. Yeah. Thank you.
I think after maybe, what, a dozen tries of a restaurant there, maybe, if I'm right. I mean, man, I'm at least in the ballpark.
Many memories in that place.
Many memories, but maybe we've tried, they've tried that path enough times. Maybe that's just not going to work. Very good. Any other questions, comments? Anyone else? Very good. Thank you, Mr. Potter.
Thank you.
Did the applicant want to add? Very good. I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Clancy, second by Trustee Griffin. Any further discussion? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Nays? The ayes have it. We are at waiting. How's everybody tonight? We're going to kill about 4 minutes. First meetings don't usually go that fast. All right, it's 6:10. We can begin the regular meeting of the Village of Romeoville. It's Wednesday, February 7th, 2024 at 6:10 p.m. Can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Pallmeyer. Trustee Chavez.
Here.
Trustee Clancy.
Here.
Trustee Richards.
Here.
Trustee Griffin.
Here.
Trustee Aguirre.
Here.
Mayor Noak.
Here.
We have a quorum.
Trustee Griffin, will you lead us in the pledge?
Yes.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Very good. Thank you. All right. I don't have any sign-ins. So do we need a consent agenda? You're back, Ken. We got you for consent agenda. You got a motion? We'll let you do it. You're back now. I got a motion for consent agenda by Trustee Griffin.
Second.
Second by, I think you got that, Trustee Chavez.
Yeah.
Second by Trustee Chavez. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Trustee Aguirre.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. Within that consent agenda, then, we have minutes 2409-62, approval of minutes workshop meeting January 17th, 2024, minutes 2409-63, approval of minutes regular meeting January 17th, 2024, 2432-58, approval of Schedule A, 2432-59, approval of Schedule B, 2432-60, approved bill Schedule C, 2432-61, approved bill Schedule D, Resolution 2437-33, a resolution approving a plat of easement for Weber Road, Weber 55 Logistics Park, Resolution 2437-36, resolution approving a plat of easement for Bridge Development Partners LLC, Resolution 2437-38, a resolution waiving the formal bid process and authorizing the purchase of Total Automation Concepts, Inc. for CCTV cameras for Public Works South Plant. Resolution 2437-39, a resolution waiving the formal bid process and authorizing the purchase of Total Automation Concepts for CCTV cameras at Romeoville Crossing Park. Resolution 2437-40, resolution waiving the bid process and accepting updated sludge hauling and biosolids management program contract with Stewart Spreading. One of those wonderful ones that you send us, Mr. Dre. Resolution 2437-41, a resolution clearing surplus property and authorizing the disposition of surplus property. Resolution 2437-42, resolution waiving the bid requirements and utilizing the state bid contract for the purchase of two 2023 Ford F-150 police responders.
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Griffin.
Second.
Second by Trustee Aguirre. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin.
Aye.
Trustee Aguirre.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez.
Aye.
Trustee Clancy.
Aye.
Trustee Richards.
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. Mayor's report. My first item is we have a 2432-56 proclamation declaring February 2024 as Black History Month in the Village of Romeoville. Do I have a motion?
So moved.
Second.
That was like everybody. I'm going to give the motion to Trustee Chavez. Second, but Trustee Aguirre. She actually said second. Chavez and Aguirre. Any further discussion? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Nays? The ayes have it. Proclamation declaring February 2024 as Black History Month in the Village of Romeoville, whereas Black History Month celebrates the contributions, culture, and achievements of African Americans in our society, while also acknowledging the racism and challenges that they have had to overcome and continue to fight, and whereas Dr. Carter G. Woodson, founder of the Association of Study of African American History, presented the first Black History Week in February 1926, and President Gerald Ford issued the first presidential proclamation in 1976 declaring it Black History Month, and whereas the month of February was chosen because of the birthdays of President Abraham Lincoln and abolitionist Frederick Douglass both occurred during the month, and whereas Romeoville is a community where diversity and inclusion are encouraged and celebrated. Now, therefore, I, Mayor John D. Noak, on behalf of the Village of Romeoville, proclaim February 2024 as Black History Month. Very good. Thank you. Rest of my report. It feels like a little while, but it hasn't been too long. We had quite a bit happening, though, the last couple of weeks or so. We had the Chamber Installation Dinner Awards Gala. Really well done. If you get a chance to see any of the people or organizations that were recognized, whether they were mentioned and put up for an award or they won an award, really just an amazing group all the way around. I mean, some of those categories, it's hard to choose who should have gotten the award, but just a wonderful group. Great group of leaders that make up that chamber board. I'm very happy that they continue to serve the community. Also, I got the opportunity to go over to Creekside Elementary School, and it's been a while. I used to go, we did this a lot before COVID, and, you know, during the COVID years, they had to stop doing it and go over to the class and talk about their community and government section of the lessons they were learning. And it was nice to be able to come back. It was the first year we were able to do it. Really just a smaller group this time, but just a really wonderful group of kids. It was really nice to be over there. Hosted another ride around town with the chamber, some chamber members. That was a nice trip around. Bolingbrook, I want to congratulate them on their State of the Village. Turned out nice. And if you didn't catch it online or the broadcast, we had their annual basketball game with the Northern Will County Special Rec. And wow, it was the biggest turnout ever. And I want to thank everybody who played, everybody who took part in putting it together. It's just a really wonderful occasion that everybody comes together annually. Very, very nice thing. I'm going to keep it short because we have a short meeting tonight, and I'm going to move on and let the clerk report.
Thank you, Mayor Noak. Community Service Council had not had a meeting since my last update, so the next meeting is scheduled for Wednesday, March 13th at 2:30 p.m. Valley View Educational Enrichment Foundation next meeting is February 22nd at 7 o'clock p.m. Now, in the meanwhile, we are working on the annual fundraiser auction dinner this year. Some of you might have seen this flyer that I put at your desk, and there are some over on the table. The theme this year is cruising, so we are encouraging you to come out and sail away with the Valley View Educational Enrichment Foundation. As you may recall, the money that's raised from these annual dinners, auctions, are for the Valley View schools. Each year, teachers could request money. They have to submit an application for a scholarship, and the money is used for their classrooms. So it's something that is really, I think, very well attended, and most people, when they attend, are pretty pleased at what is being done each year. And hopefully you will participate. And I would like to thank Mayor Noak, Dawn, on behalf of the Village of Romeoville, for contributing to the foundation. Actually, they donated the silver sponsorship for Valley View, which is very nice. And thank you. That's the end of my report. Hope to see you all on March 15th.
Thank you. We'll just roll our committee reports into board comments, if that's okay with everyone. Village manager's report.
Just a couple quick comments. I just want to congratulate Alex from the Rec Center on his article. The board has a copy of his article on the Aquatic Center that was featured in the World Water Park magazine. So congratulations to Alex. Did a great job on that. As you mentioned, the SRA game was a really great, it was a great turnout. I want to thank all the departments for coming out for that. We had a lot of support from the departments, and the participants from SRA is probably the most I've ever seen. So it was really nice to see that. In addition to that, Jimmy John's is open, as many of you know, so I just want to give that a quick update. And as well as the mayor, all the department managers are also heading over to Creekside to have some discussions with the students over there. So they've been super excited about that as well. So that's it.
Very good. And for those who keep wondering, one of the main holdups on the Jimmy John's was transformers from combat, I believe, another one issue and hooking up electricity. It's unfortunately very common. It's very common all throughout in the region. Not the only part of their delay, but definitely a significant portion of it. So new business. It's only two of them you want to take. Yeah. Usually. All right. Ordinance 24-1898, an ordinance approving the rezoning of the territory at 201 East Romeo Road.
So motion.
Second.
Motion by Trustee Griffin, second by Trustee Clancy. Any further discussion? Can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Trustee Richards?
Aye.
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
Trustee Gary?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. Next, we have Ordinance 24-1899, Ordinance Approving Special Use Permit for Planning and Development, Final Development Plan for Vampinterina Properties, LLC for 201 East Rover Road.
So moved.
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Griffin.
Say second. Second.
Second by Trustee Clancy. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please? Thanks.
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee Richards?
Aye.
Trustee Gary?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Very good. Board comments, Trustee Chavez, we'll start with you.
Yes, thank you, Mayor. Just want to start off by wishing all the dads and daughters the best of fun on this coming Saturday at the Enchanted Ball again at the Rec Center. I hear that's going very well. How many years is that now, Kelly? About, it's been a while, right? It's going, and we have a good turnout, which is good. And then glad to see that our public works is staying on top of our biosolids management program. Thank you very much. It's always good to know. And I had to throw that in there. And glad to see that we're continuing our efforts to get cameras in our parks for safety. It's all about safety. So I'm glad to see that that's still work in progress, and we're adding them to the newer parks that are coming. And I just want to remind everybody that the free event's coming up for the first 50 kids with the police department. They're doing this again and did it the last couple of years, a Nerf to Protect, ages 11 to 14. It's scheduled for March 23rd. You can register by March 13th at the Rec Center. It's free and it's similar to paintball. It's a lot of fun. I saw some pictures and got a report from last year, and it's a good time. I think it's a real good event for the kids and the police officers to hook up. And with that, Super Bowl Sunday, can't wait. Should be fun. That's all I have, Mayor.
Very good. Trustee Griffin.
Thank you, Mark. I want to piggyback on what Clerk Holloway was talking about. On March the 15th is the Valley View Educational Foundation dinner and fundraiser. And as we do every year, we're calling on merchants and businesses in the area to donate prizes. All of this money goes directly to the kids here in town, so I hope you'll be generous when myself or somebody else calls you and hits you up for a gift card or something. And that's all I've got.
Good. Trustee Clancy, please.
Thank you. Keep Romeoville Beautiful Commission. The next meeting will be March 7th at 4 o'clock here at the Village Hall. And like it was mentioned already, be our guest. The Enchanted Ball, Saturday, February 10th. and they were going to have magic, food, dancing, and other greetings by Belle and Prince. And the rest, any questions, dial 1-815-886-6222. The Aquatic Center is having a Valentine's Day special, buy one, get one free swimming session on Wednesday, the 14th. And then, as everybody else said, that was a tremendous basketball game. And everyone is known possibly by watching games on TV that they're always four quarters. There was such a big turnout. That was the first five-quarter basketball game that I attended. And it was tremendous. That's how good a turnout it was. It was tremendous. And then the Athletic Event Center is hosting the Big Classic Gymnast Meet February 16th to the 18th. There will be over 500 gymnasts in attendance. And that'd be it for me. Thank you.
Yep, five quarters. And it's really great to see a program like that really thrive and grow. You know, we've merged some with some other organizations to really provide some really first-class special recreation opportunities. And I can't say enough about the staff over there. They just do an amazing job. And the participants are some of the best families and people you'll ever meet. Trustee Richards, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. A couple of things. The Planning and Zoning Commission will hold a meeting on February 13th. Right now on that agenda is the Sable Creek Winery PUD, and there's also a concept plan for another new business coming to town. So they will have a meeting on the 13th right here in the boardroom, 6 p.m. To build again on what Trustee Griffin added for the Enrichment Foundation, keep in mind, folks, that all these local businesses support these kids. They support the foundation, which that money goes back to the children, then in the district. Please support your local businesses. Go out and support your local businesses. They are here for anyone that asks whenever we need donations for things. So please go out and support them as well. They appreciate it and they need it. And then last but not least, obviously the basketball game last night was phenomenal. I'm a little past my playing days, but it was great to be there. I used to embarrass myself gladly at that game, but not anymore. That organization has grown huge, and we keep bringing in more and more people from the village to try and offset it. At one point, we were down so much it was embarrassing. We fought hard, came back, made it respectable. Those men and women that are part of the Northern Will County Rec are just an amazing group of young men and women, all ages men and women, and it was great to see them there. Good time had by all. Great parent support for the players, great village support for all sides. So good night overall. That's all I have.
Very good. Trustee Gere, please.
Thank you, Mayor. Let's see here. For our fire and police meeting, it's Tuesday, February 13th at 6:30. And the commission is currently working on the oral testing for the police eligibility list. So that's getting updated. Conservation and Sustainability meeting is going to be Wednesday, March 13th at 6 p.m. That's every other month. And I want to mention the game last night with the basketball for the SRA. Great group, and I'm happy to see that the fire department, the police officers, and village participants survived. So I didn't know, another community to come save any of the guys. But anyways, it all worked out good for the young ladies. And I took my first water exercise class over at the Aquatic Center. Our village has done a superb job of having this phenomenal facility there. There's nothing easy about water aerobics. But you just don't look like you're sweating. That's about it. But my arms hurt in the morning and my legs were hurting. So I still have to get into that, aquatic community and wear the right clothes and towels and all that good stuff. But please join, look up for those classes. I went to an evening class. It's phenomenal. And happy Valentine's Day to everybody and your loved ones. That's all I have. Thank you.
Very good. Motion to adjourn.
So moved.
So moved.
Second.
Oh, motion by Trustee Clancy. Second by Trustee Geary. Any further discussion? Hearing none. Can I get all those in favor signify by saying aye?
Aye.
Nays? The ayes have it.